What up?
What up, what up, what up, what up?
Premium Product Podcast. So what were you saying, Jarrell, about...
Which subject?
Your car getting declined at the club?
Bro, so ran the tab up to like a light 350, 370.
It's crazy. 10 years ago, that would be crazy to me.
Bro, that Vidor's, that's a chicken sandwich and a fishbowl with a good server, bro.
A good day.
This is a Tuesday morning.
Discounts. Early bird special.
Bro, I run at the tab. I'm like, I got it. She comes back. She's like, hey.
Don't you hate that?
Whispered on your ear, bro.
Hot ass breath.
Hey.
Your car got too close.
Like, shh. When you speak it too loud.
You immediately go to the bank account on your phone. You show, hey, no, look at my phone, bro. I got it, bro. You show her your car keys. I got a house, bro. What do you mean?
You don't know how many people would get like that at Olive Garden back when I used to work there. They'd be like, I got fucking money. Like,
bro, they tell you how much they make an hour, their insurance, bro. I pay my mama's bills, bro. What do you mean?
Did you do it?
Yeah. 3 minutes.
Damn, I don't even have the soundboard like out to like
I didn't
get you
quick.
Any problems.
I was looking, I was like, Jesus, bro, it's been three minutes.
It came out. Not even 3 minutes. That was like a minute.
Fucking bank text me. Are you sure?
Damn. I'm gonna stop bringing
you.
Wow. Joshua, yeah. Wow. You're wowing me.
Oh, yeah, I had to, bro. I had to make myself some sort of like.
Wow.
Because if I remember a certain.
Wrong one.
I don't have any of them.
No, there's one that's like a car crash, I know.
We don't have the car crash. That's an add in.
Oh, wow.
I can set it up in a second, maybe.
No, that's fine. That's fine. We'll do that on another one.
Fuck, I'll have to set it up for the second one because we don't have the.
He did it on purpose. You see how hard he hit that F?
Can we stop saying it? Jesus Christ.
We're not with cuss like this. Yeah, we do.
Yes, we do.
You cuss more.
No, I don't.
Bro, yesterday, me, Joshua, and the homies went out to eat at where Leo was working at.
Leo?
Yeah, at his
taco spot.
Yeah.
Okay.
We don't downtown.
We're going to keep that.
I got rest. You. We're sitting in the back of the restaurant for a reason.
Sherman.
Away from everyone.
I was gonna say, damn, y'all got a spot out here. Y'all
bro, it's delicious.
It's good.
Yeah. It's so good.
I wouldn't say
free margarita.
It's good. It's good.
It's delicious to me. Good to him for some reason, like he's fucking Gordon Ramsay.
Can we stop cussing though?
No, I'm just from Mexico.
I mean, fuck it at this point.
You know. Yeah, I'm gonna see if I can still hit 10 minutes myself.
I could cut out the other ones, but.
I'm proud of myself so far.
But anyway,
like I've said before, we play copyrighted music.
Yeah.
That's the main reason. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry. Look. If they come at you, I'll pitch in for the lawyer.
I'll just have to take the episode out or cut it out.
I feel like it's gonna be a good one.
No, I mean they're not gonna come at us. We don't have that many subscribers. No, we're not 400,000.
We're good.
I share them when I get them, when I see them.
Good. Thank you. We appreciate that.
I love the support, the homies.
We'll get to it later. You know this. You know, like and subscribe.
Yeah.
Always.
But, you know, I've had my car decline at Astroworld as I was buying them all that merch.
Bro, and then it's not like you can just turn around. Give me one second.
I was waiting 4 hours for merch.
There's 4,000 people behind you.
Yeah. And then I'm there like, so you're going to get another card? I'm like... Yeah, let me give my other card. And right when I did that, my bank.
And it's not like you can text them back and like, hey,
no,
signal.
No. They sent me a notification.
That's what happened
to me. And it said, is this you? Yeah. Like, are you doing this much in Houston randomly? And I'm like, yeah, that's me. And like, okay.
They allow it.
We'll allow it. And then I'm like, hey, it's hard again. My bank just texted me. Showing them.
Yep.
You know, you got to show the text.
Okay,
just text me.
Chase?
Yeah.
Chase the money. I went to San Diego and I bought some stuff over there, and when I bought it they were like, hey, like this is like kind of random, you know,
cause I remember you telling me when you went with
I tell Ruben my bank.
Yeah, and y'all left from me.
Yeah, I tell my bank that I'm leaving. When I left Mexico, I told my bank, like, hey, I'm going to go to Mexico. So if y'all see any charges from Mexico, it's from me. I'll be here from here this time to this time. If it's not me, I will call.
Yeah.
You know, because that's embarrassing. Knowing you have the money and then getting declined.
Oh, yeah, like, bro. I'm telling you, people get so offended when you tell them that the car got declined.
If you broke, just say that.
Just
say that.
They will show you their bank account. It's like, look how much money I make. I'm like, I'm just telling you that it didn't go through, bro. Like, it could be 100 reasons. Like, it doesn't mean that you don't have money.
Yeah.
But they will get so offended.
Yeah, dude. I'll be like, Cash App Olive Garden right now. You won't.
Like, what do you want me to do? Like,
yeah, you won't right now. Do it.
Hey, Colin, I haven't forgot about our Germany trip, so I hope you've been thinking about that.
When is that supposed to happen?
Yeah, I don't think it's been set in stone.
We talked about it because he was saying how he went to Germany, and I was like, I want to fucking go. And I was like,
I believe we talked about it last time everybody was there.
It was the birthday one.
Yeah, your birthday one.
It was not my birthday, but it was it was the one of the slides. I remember I posted on my story. It was like it was birthday something with some balloons.
Yeah.
Regardless of anything to do, that's what I remember that as the birthday one.
Okay.
Yeah, that's crazy.
We talk about some crazy shit out here.
Yeah.
You know, and I love that you give us the opportunity to do that because.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I'm a big free speech guy.
Yeah, super free speech.
Because me and Josh, we'll talk about the things. We're like, bro, were you listening?
The random ass shit we talk about, bro, is crazy.
I'll be at work listening to them sometimes. I'm just like, bro. And they'll look at me like, what's so funny? I'm like, You wouldn't get it. Wait, like and subscribe, though. Like and subscribe.
Check it out. You might get it.
Work asked me, like, because they tell them what I do on the weekends. They always ask what I do on the weekends. I'm like, I'm going to go record a podcast.
My job don't give a fuck what I do.
You're wild for...
And I'm like, I record a podcast. They don't ask the name or anything.
Yeah.
Because they're just like...
Yeah, but your job, I've worked with the parts that your job produces. They try to be, like, top secret on that shit. So they're like...
You know, I can tell you.
You can't because I've worked there too, and then I've also worked on the places that your parts produced.
Yeah,
you know.
This is the public episode.
Yeah, I know. That's we're not saying what I do, but parts. Yeah,
yeah. They make essential.
Yeah, very essential parts.
Very essential parts.
Very essential parts.
Every time you go to the gas station, essential
masks.
Parts.
Yeah.
That. Mask.
Yeah.
We
going in public.
Now we create the little bands on the mask.
They created COVID.
Yeah, oh, sure did.
They put the C in COVID.
Yeah. No, we put the V in COVID. The V in COVID.
The V in COVID, man.
Yeah. Oh, man, that's funny as shit.
Come on, I was talking to the homie Blitcher.
Okay, I like that.
Talking to the homie Blitcher.
Yeah. That's not the one.
Damn it.
We just talked about not having any of the soundboards, and you still...
That's horn jazz.
What is it with boys? We started talking about our jaws, and we show them... Everybody got a picture with what they do. Yeah, I did that.
Yeah, I don't take pictures of my stuff,
bro. Him,
bro. He would take, be telling you exactly what he does, bro. And nobody understands
like,
shit.
And then tell you how to exactly build all the parts we did, word for word. You're like, I can't.
I didn't have an appreciation to it until my last job,
and you saw it.
And then we were doing what I was doing as my part. With that, I was like, damn, that's crazy.
Yeah, Jarrell be showing me fucking pictures of what he did, but he'd be like, look, bro, I built this. Oh, look, bro, I also made this.
Yeah. Naughty on West Texas.
I'll be in the, I'll call it the special room, because then I don't want to say, but I'm in the special room where, like if I don't do the right procedure. If I don't do the right procedure on my job, she can go south really bad.
Oh yeah,
like catastrophic. So,
oh bro,
but I'm sure they supervise like the piece at the end. No,
if I had a dollar for every time I fucked up at work, bro,
Do you think the inspector is just kind of like, oh yeah, it looks good?
No, is it inspector or is it QC?
No, QC don't do shit.
It has to be. Someone has to supervise the last product. Like someone.
Yeah.
Has to, like,
yeah. Quality control.
Only
if it gets a special process. If not, once it's on the line. It's out the door.
Talk about
only thing that protects you is that if the inspector signs off on it,
bro.
Which I'm sure he gets to. No,
no. Our inspector's been there for
shit.
Our youngest inspector's been working there for 20 plus years.
What's the deal with that generation? She's 65. Exactly. People born before 1979. Staying in a job for 10. I'm like, you know, you can do something else.
There's the guy who has the highest seniority in our plant. It works in my department. Started working there as his first job at 18. Jesus. When the plant opened 6 months later.
When you could say ning on the job.
For sure.
When they had a whites only fountain.
They had a color bathroom.
Damn.
Hey, what are you doing in here?
I think that's the restroom in our department because it looks worse than all the other restrooms.
Nah, because meeting C-line, been there for a minute.
Yeah.
Been there for since like the 60s.
Yeah, same here.
Jeez.
But the funny thing is that like he's been there 6 months after the plant opened. He's like, I think 45 years.
That becomes a reality.
He doesn't even look that old.
Grandparents.
He don't even. Oh, this man could be easy, like waiting for his great grandchild.
Jesus.
And the thing is, he's not the oldest person in the plant.
Your granny at 35.
The oldest person in our plant is one of our inspectors, and he's 77 this year.
Go home.
You know what he says? Keeps him young.
His son keeps asking for money.
No. His grandson's an engineer there. His son, you know what keeps him old? Flirting with the young girls.
Hey,
horny.
Hey, you walk past me one more time, I'm gonna fuck you.
This is what he does. This is what he does. When a girl passes, hey, so and so, how's your day? Oh, it just got better.
Girl
looked like a scrub.
Bro, whole time he's saying this dick.
Bro, he had a 10-minute conversation with my area of the department.
And you know how he keeps You know how he kept his dick up all the time? Blue Chew. You
know. He said he don't need it.
They're not paying.
No, bro, he's capping.
It'd be crazy though if Blue Chew came in and sponsored us for a commercial.
Oh, that's crazy.
I've heard Blue Chew is fucking amazing. So yeah. y'all should reach out to us.
Yeah,
hit us for the app.
Yeah,
you know, Blue Chew. Yeah, shout out.
He was telling me that he like.
I'm gonna say fuck Blue Chew until they pay me. Pay me some money.
Fuck Cialis. Fuck Viagra.
Come on.
Fuck Colin. For keeps.
I'll go to the gas station.
Get the rhino pill?
I need you to
buy
whatever.
Bro, this man buy the honey pack.
Man, the honey pack ain't gonna do shit for me, but.
Take four of them hoes.
I take four honey packs. You ain't gonna see me for a minute.
I feel bad for an eating girl.
Get over here. Yeah, come here.
Scorpion, that bitch. No, man. But yeah, he's like that dude's. Like, I asked him, like, hey, why don't you retire? He goes, I'm still young. I can still walk, and there's plenty of honey to talk to. And I'm like, bro, you so horny.
Hey,
he always tells me the reason why I married my wife is because she got big titties, and she's 10 years younger than me.
Nice. Like,
so she's 67. She's still old.
God, that's gonna be us one day. Yeah, she's
don't
10 years.
Don't fuck with his head. That's young pussy.
That's young pussy.
That's young pussy for him, bro.
Hey, bro.
It's that prime puss.
As long as you believe it, it is.
Joshua,
what it is.
You know me. I worked in healthcare for.
You yeah. probably see some
5+ years, bro.
Some stanky cud,
bro. Highest rate of STDs in nursing homes.
Oh, I bet.
Oh, they don't care.
Oh yeah.
Oh, okay, they're at the end of their life.
If you're like 80 something years old, still able to fuck.
What are you afraid of?
No, what are you afraid of? I'm busting in any
Straight powder, bro. Straight powder. Straight powder.
You could literally, fuck a bitch to death.
You could.
She ain't no bitch. That's somebody's grandma. Yeah.
She my bitch. She my bitch tonight. Hey, that's your granny. She my bitch.
Gummy.
Actually,
come on, Mima.
Mima. Come on, Gladys.
Go.
Gladys, get your fat ass over here.
Go ahead and pull that dick out, boy. I'm ready for it.
Get over here, Rhonda.
Hey, bro. Hey. Hey.
Hey.
That's your grandma.
That's what that means, bro.
Oh, my man.
You need to chill out.
Talk about my grandma right now, bro.
Oh, my man.
Chill out. Chill out, Consuela.
Consuela.
Guadalupe.
Doggy afuera. Doggy afuera.
Hey, bro, hold on. What you got on the screen over there?
Oh, yeah, that's we'll for later. We'll get there in a minute. We're just, you know, riffing. Yeah, we'll talk about
just those. Joshing around.
I would wear those to a wedding, bro. Is it?
I wore sneakers to a wedding multiple times.
The SpongeBob SquarePants Crocs.
The Patrick Stars.
Yeah,
yeah, that's seen those. They also coming out with the Naruto's, but we'll talk about that in a little bit. Well, not those. It's Crocs.
Damn,
those. What are those Dutches?
Them shoes gonna be $1,100.
What are the
retail?
Oh, these just came out.
Anything
they told me to try these out and let them know how much it is.
You see, you see them?
Yeah,
bro. Them going to be minimum $1,300 to $1,200 resale on StockX.
No,
13. You don't think 100? Bro,
Travis Scott wave is not as big as it was before.
Bro, them.
Yeah, I guess just
no. That's what I'm saying. I'm saying. I know.
I'm looking at a picture of the Travis Scott Jordan jumping or Jumpman Jack.
His signature sneaker.
Yeah, his first.
Is that what
shoe?
What shoe? Exactly.
What shoe shape is that?
It's his own. Like that's a mid.
It looks like a Jordan
1. Like
no. Looks like a mid Jordan 1.
Yeah.
A little bit above a high, a little bit below a high top, a little bit below,
it's
little bit
above sneaker. A low.
It's a Nike.
Yeah, it's a mid.
I don't love that.
The cream sole, bro. What do you mean?
I don't love the mid fit.
But it's not. It doesn't look like a mid, bro.
They're nice.
I forget what the tooling is like from one Nike shoe.
Yeah,
the
sole
is almost like a Nike mid, and then it has a strap over it.
It has a strap over the foot.
Yeah,
not for me.
I don't care for the strap over the foot just because
these will go up to $800.
I think they'll resell.
I think they'll be like five.
I think they're really.
Yeah, I think it's an inline Jordan. Yeah, they never do well.
I think it's a team
Jordan.
Yeah, I think it'll do 800 at like the most.
You don't think?
Yeah,
it's a team Jordan.
You don't think his name
with Travis Scott brand?
Exactly.
No.
I know. Okay.
Not all the time. His Jordan 33 Travis Scott.
When was the last time like a team Jordan has like even the Spizike like doesn't do great?
It had
literally
its moment.
Like maybe the OG pair and maybe the bread.
Yeah. Well, you know, shoes are my forte.
But like, I don't know. It's just
for me. That's for sure.
I like them. I fuck with them. I would buy them.
Don C got his own model. Nobody really like.
Yeah, but who is he? Who is he influencing right now?
A lot of people.
I mean, Kid Cudi wore them on Kid See Ghost. Like an all green pair.
Kid Cudi's huge, bro.
Who gives a fuck about Kid Cudi?
It was a big album.
Come on now,
you a Lupe fan?
You cannot disrespect Kid Cudi like
Kick. And push. Fuck Kid Cudi.
If you're listening to this, actually, the next day, Wednesday, I go to a comic book store and Kid Cudi drops his first issue of his comic with Image.
Yeah, I'm going to take a shit in the comic book, have him sign it.
It's crazy. You're such a Kid Cudi hater.
I am. Why? I really
you're
am.
You're a Kid Cudi fan.
Bro, because support a local comic book shop. I was raised by Lupe Fiasco.
But they're friends now.
They're cool. Because he can't handle the hate.
You can't like two different artists?
No, I can't. I love Kanye, Drake. I love Pusha T, Meek Mill. I love French Montana.
Do you really feel like Lupe Fiasco was bigger than Kid Cudi?
In my time, when I was downloading his music overall, on the MP3, bro, I would be going. I would be going to Dillingham with Lupe Fiasco every field trip, blasting Lupe Fiasco.
No, you sound good.
Lupe Fiasco was such a big part of my life, way more than bro. Even when Kid Cudi was coming out, I was like, man, this dude is mid as fuck. And I feel like I'm musically inclined. Like I never gave a fuck about Kid Cudi. That's my personal opinion.
Okay, yeah.
People like him. He's just not for me. I never gave a fuck about Kid Cudi.
I think Men in the Moon was a fucking fantastic fucking album.
Dude. And I listened to every song and I thought it was
mid.
I had to force myself to maybe I was prejudiced towards it, but even then I'm a fan. Bro, Joshua, you know I'm a fan of music.
Yeah, I've heard the view.
I just could not get into it. I thought it was mid as fuck. I thought he just hummed his way through it. I love every joke against Kid Cudi because I think it's bleh. I love him. I love all the jokes towards him. And then when he started beefing with everybody because he started getting irrelevant, man, get out of here.
Damn.
Question, are your headphones connected?
Yeah, I hear y'all.
Oh, okay, I see the wire now because I thought it was like wireless or something.
No, he has just a really long
cord. I hear y'all.
Okay.
Speaking of Blue Chew and podcast related shit, you just hit a fume.
Yes.
What do those do?
It helps you kick the habit from vaping.
Okay.
Really?
But you were just vaping a second ago.
I tried it. No, I tried this one because this one looked nice, but it hits a little too hard for me. So I put it down. I don't want it.
And that's on the two hole. That's not even the three hole.
Well, I don't even know what the fuck that means. But yeah.
Two in the pink, one in the stink.
Okay.
Okay. Has it been working?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, the mint capsule in there, and it straight up is like mint, like. Your breath tastes a little minty.
We were supposed to kick the vape this year, dog.
Like, look.
I mean, it's still January. You go.
Yeah.
See, we got four days left.
Before I turn 30.
Yeah. All it is this.
You turn 30 June.
I know.
That's it. 6th.
Exactly. I have 5 months.
30.
You're not going to stop vaping. Don't lie to yourself.
Dobeezy.
You don't
because,
know. You don't
because
know
why do you have to? Why you have to wait 5 months when you can just do it now?
Do it now. Okay. What's stopping you?
Yeah.
Oh, just put this bitch.
Oh yeah, so throw it away.
Throw it away.
What's more?
What's $20?
What's $20 or your health?
Versus your health. You know how much a long trash can.
He ain't doing it. I know that look. He's like, fuck y'all. I'm keeping this bitch.
I'm just saying. You know how much a lung doctor cost?
Yeah, a lot.
Just for the visit, not including the medicine you gonna need.
That's okay.
To breathe.
That's visits. Okay. Like cardiologist. My cardiologist, I'm glad I only have to go once a year. I have to save up for that.
Hey, but you good now, though.
Yeah, I'm good.
Worth the investment.
It's worth the investment, but, you know.
You was walking around looking like house for a minute.
I was raised in Mexico, so I'm immune.
You're immune to heart problems?
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Super cool, man. Good point.
That's exactly how the heart muscle works. Oh, no, but he's from Mexico, bro. He's good. He's good. Yeah. Hell no.
How many family members you know have died from heart problems?
Not that many.
Mexican and black men.
Not that many, actually.
Are higher.
I can say a few, but not that many.
How much is a few?
Joshua.
Six.
I was going to say more than two.
Joshua, when you go, your family.
That's a lot of money.
Two is a few. Six is like, okay. There might be an issue here.
Those have been like four relatives, you know?
If anything, a gene skips.
Do they, like, on what side? Like your dad or your.
His mom's.
My mom's.
His mom's.
My mom's, yeah. My dad's, no. My dad's.
Your dad looks really healthy.
From all I know, like, my dad's family have been, like, pretty good.
Yeah, your dad looks. He looked real young when I saw a recent picture. He looked real young. Muy guapo.
Gracias.
He's probably eating just plants.
But
no, indigenous. No, stuff. Bro. Do you know my dad?
No, I've never met your dad.
You see his son, bro? He ain't pussy. You pussy.
I am what I eat.
Got him.
I'll drink to that. I'll drink to that.
I'll drink to that too, my brother.
I am. I don't know what to say. I can say one thing, though.
I love you and pussy, bro. I love you and pussy. I love it.
You ever had a stinky one and you just kept going?
Oh, yes. You just got off work?
Say less.
Where's my beer, bro? I need my beer. God damn.
I can taste your whole day, girl. You had lunch at 11:30.
Chicken salad.
Oh my God, how'd you know? You're crazy. Stop it.
Bitch, what do you mean? What do I know?
You went to Cheddar's after him. Spinning an artichoke dip. I taste it. Yeah. I taste it.
Yeah. Just a little spinach, bro.
Hey, any dude you see in public with a toothpick in his mouth is the dude we're talking about right now, bro. Just walk around. He wants to taste it all day, bro.
Oh, you just came from the gym?
Oh, okay.
Let me taste. Let me smell.
Let me buy you a drink.
Let me smell.
Let me buy you something.
Oh, my God.
Wait, you meant to start your period in 2 days, huh? Oh, I took it too far there.
Hey, bro. It's all fun and games until a girl comes up to you and do that.
What?
Just, you just got off work.
Tripping. I'm like, bitch, get off me.
She'd be like, oh, you got a fart, huh? Dude. Bro, that's my girl. She's like, you got a fart, huh? Dude.
Oh my God.
Do it.
Do it right now.
Do it.
You won't.
Do it.
You won't. She hit you with the you won't.
She hit you with the you. She do with the you won't, and then she'll cock back. Do it.
Yeah.
That's
I gotta go.
Yes in the handle. Yes
in the handle. She's like, let me in.
Bro, it sounds like a Peterbilt going down the house.
She's knocking on the door in the bathroom. Let me in. Why you always lock the door?
Oh, bro, she ain't gonna She don't give a fuck.
That's steady. Be like, nah, my girl be like, oh, you going to restaurant? I'll go with you. I'm like, girl, sit down.
Oh, no.
I'm about to destroy this restroom. I don't want to hear you complaining.
My girl knows better not to go to the restroom when I go to the restroom, bro. That's
Joshua, when you shit, bro.
Oh, my God.
I think you need to see somebody.
The beer shits, dog. Los Topos.
He's the Picasso of painting. Bulls, bro.
Those Topos. Explosive.
Maybe stop drinking them, dog.
You should definitely stop drinking them if they're doing that to you.
Every time I think of Seltzer now, though, I think of fucking Kurt's bit he did at that beginning.
But you got the fake White Claws?
Fake White Claws?
Yeah. Yes, I drink White Claws.
Well, they don't have that much fucking sugar. Fucking White Claws, bro.
Yeah, but how much you drink?
Not that many.
Seltzer, you know, is like horrible for your teeth.
Well, I don't drink them no more. Now I drink Michelob's.
You went back to the mix?
I did.
Why? Too much sugar?
$1 a beer.
Careful with that word, too.
What does Mick rhyme with?
$1 a beer, baby.
But it is a slur as well.
Go to Sam's.
Yeah.
Mick for Irish.
I think Scottish.
Scottish. Potato, potato.
Different.
Viking is a Viking, bro. They were fighting each other.
They're Highlanders.
One's a proud people. One's a bunch of drunks.
I'll let you choose which ones.
Which I'll choose. Irish, Italian here.
Yeah.
Whatever you think is the first race that popped up in your head as a drunk isn't one it is. So.
Wow.
Mexicans.
You said it, not me, brother.
We are drunk.
No, none of those, I guess, European slurs
matter.
Spanish people are fucking drunk. And there's no...
No, you don't say.
Dude, they're fucking drunks.
You know how much they drink? They have... Spanish people have a siesta.
Yeah, they stay.
Hi, Irish Italian here. I can relay.
The club hours start at 2 a.m. That's when the club hours start. Like anything before that is
just
like
European lifestyle, man.
Is the pregame. So if you pregame from 8 to 2 a.m., that's just a pregame.
But don't they have just dinner life at 10? In
what is it?
They have dinner at 10.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
like, they eat really late. It makes sense. Yeah. They eat late. Yeah. So right after dinner, you get off. It's 12:30. You go to like the little pregame spot.
That's terrible for you. I bet they get a bunch of cancer for that.
No,
shit.
But no, they stay up. That's the thing.
24-hour lifestyle.
Yeah, they're just getting drunk, doing drugs, Molly, ecstasy, hash. Maybe the old school opium.
I do want to go to.
I think they have weed legalized in
they
Spain.
You have to.
In Spain.
Yes, they do. Yeah. George bought weed in Spain at the weed club. You have to.
Yeah, I was looking at going like to the Canaries and shit because they have like dispensaries out there.
You have to sign up. You have to be part of a member. So all you have to do is go to this one of their memberships or their store. Sign up to be a member. Once you're a member, you can then come in and buy. But you got to smoke at the shop. Legally, you're not allowed to smoke on the street.
That's fun.
Yeah, I'm like, I'll get high as shit right here real quick. Where you going? You leaving? Bye.
You dipping?
No. Watch out. All right, you good? You got your bathroom? Yeah. Oh, well, the bathroom's right there. You literally get
this in baño?
You just told me get up. I have a long cord. Yeah, you went all around the world. That's crazy. You good?
Oh, geez.
I don't know why we sat him by the power cord.
I don't. That's on us.
Man, that movie was crazy, bro.
We'll talk about it later. I just don't like Minnesotans because of that.
All I could think of was what's the dude from Reno 911 that played Terry?
I'm not a Reno 911 fan.
Terry, the brown hair girl?
No, it was Nick Swartzen, comedian.
That's a guy, yeah.
Nick Swartzen?
I'm sure, yeah.
Yeah, the one
Minnesota?
Player
brought,
he's I don't know if he's from Minnesota or not. But
he's on Reno 911. He's on
he might, yeah.
Grown Ups.
I know who he is, yeah.
Was,
I'm just not. I don't really fuck with Reno 911.
Yeah, he was on Reno 911 a bunch.
Yeah, I fuck with Reno 911.
I don't know if he's from Minnesota though.
He's from Minnesota.
I don't know.
Cause he's a he always
about to fat check you.
Like all of his stand up is about him being a Vikings fan, and then
And
then one of his jokes was how about what's his name?
He was born in Minneapolis, Minnesota. Yep.
Yeah. Aaron Rodgers came up to him and he was like, "Hey man, I'm a fan. You should come hang out." Yeah. And at first, Nick Swartzen was like, "Fuck no, because
be very careful.
I'm a Minnesota fan and
you're a Green Bay player.
Fuck Green Bay, and I know you're cool as shit. And if I hang out with you, I'm gonna be best friends, and my life's gonna be fucking over." And then he ends up hanging out with him.
It's Aaron Rodgers, bro.
Like, what the fuck?
Fuck you, but since
you're going to trip on shrooms, and he's going to tell you.
This is the power cord. Super Bowl. Just be careful with that. Okay.
And you're going to be like, oh my God.
Okay, I got it.
Appreciate it, my man.
I got it.
I just want some slack.
I don't want
it to be pulled out.
Next
time I just ask you.
Yeah.
No, you're good.
You can just tell me to get up because it's much easier for
so
me to get
easier,
up.
I just noticed that. I was like, damn, there's no cables over there.
Yes, mine, but I can easily move those out the way.
Look at all these, bro. I have
yeah. Here. That's why I said, like, why did you just come this way? Like,
I don't know. I just kind of did it.
Yeah, it's fine, bro. Got out of the Bendejo right there, but it's fine. Mm-hmm. Oh, but that Spanish comedian I was talking about, though, is about the guy who does a Q&A earlier. Might know who it is. It's Franco Escamilla.
Oh, of course,
bro. He is funny.
He's
like the Mexican
Kevin Hart.
Like, dude, really big out there. Who? Franco Escamilla.
bigger, like chubbier guy.
Yeah,
like,
with the glasses. He's funny as shit. He's hilarious. He works, bro. He has like 4 podcasts that come out.
Bro, he has so much fucking shit, bro. He does so.
Okay. But he has like 6 podcasts that come out, and they're funny. Each one is funny. My favorite one is the one he plays Bola Ocho, I think it's called, where he just plays billiards, pool. Yeah, he interviews somebody as they play a game of pool, and at the end of the pool game, no matter how fast or how long it takes, that's the end of the interview. They'll play pool, and then, all right, let's go record our other episode over there. This is just a game of pool. We're just going to talk.
Yeah, that motherfucker is funny.
Funny as shit.
He's been... Probably for the last 10 years, he's been huge in Mexico.
Yeah, he's big. From Monterrey, I think he's from.
I don't know where he's from, actually.
Yeah. But, all right. Let me drink my beer.
Get into some housekeeping. Bonus episodes every week, patreon.com/theppp.
A dollar a month.
This month, or every month, we do also do a movie club over there. Doing it this week on the movie Fargo.
Yes,
great movie.
Can't wait to great talk movie. About more about it.
I didn't watch it.
It's fine.
Got a Discord over there. Get you access to a bunch of stuff, like a private chat room kind of thing. Probably have a pal talk kind of thing coming soon, like a video Discord kind of.
It's gonna be dope. Get the homies on it.
Oh yeah,
you can set it up, see us maybe while we're doing the show video somewhat aspect.
Yeah,
but
there's a stream, we're streaming the show, and yes, you see somewhat. You see the raw version.
Yes,
the live version.
Maybe set up some type of call system.
Yeah.
We could take calls on the show.
I could do that as long as that's none dumb. Oh, yeah. Actually, yeah, the dumber the better.
I would love.
My name is Nate.
Someone driving down the highway calls into the show. Hey, yo, we got Terry Blacks on the phone, bro. What's going on? Hey, man. Fuck you.
That would be good.
Yeah, like, all right.
That would be good.
I'd be like,
coming to you live from.
And that was Terry. All right. Shout out Terry.
Shout out Terry, bro. Hope you have a good night.
Hope you have a great night, man. Hope get home safe.
Get him safe, bro.
Fucker. I'm like, fucker.
You motherfucker, bro. you can't sneeze.
Bro, stop rubbing your eye and grab that hoe. Damn.
Coming back to you live. This activity.
Our Twitter is @the_ppp_. Instagram is
Premium Progs Podcast.
Mm-hmm. And I think that's
it.
Yeah. Oh, and Reddit r/ppp.
Yeah.
Not ours, but we want to take over. So please.
Yeah, take it over. Not affiliated with us.
Yeah, just take it over. Just why not?
Not affiliated with us or anything.
Yeah. There. Just if you whatever you
it's kind of wild.
Yeah, whatever you post. But we watch
it's like some Turkish guy.
He can say we follow
some Turkish guy. People. Yeah, I didn't make it. I saw it.
Yeah.
Joined it and was like posting just memes.
The manifesto.
And then people start posting manifestos and Chinese.
Yeah. It's pretty dope.
People were posting like just pictures of shit.
Yeah. Memes.
And I'm not like just saying that to be like stuff. Like literal shit.
Literal poop. I showed y'all last time, right? Yeah. I remember showing y'all.
It's gross.
Do you want to see it?
No, you should get it. That's when he went out and he went to the bathroom.
Oh yeah.
Oh damn.
Yeah, that's when you dipped off.
I died that night.
Yeah, you did.
I died.
You left literally in the middle.
I died
literally in the middle of the podcast.
Jesus, take me.
And you're like, I'm like, you good? You go like, nah, I'm done.
Yeah, I was done too. Could not make it.
Could not, bro. You saw me 2 hours prior to that.
Oh, no, yeah. You were fighting demons the entire night.
¿Qué quieres? ¿Qué onda?
You see the corn?
He needs to see a fucking doctor, bro.
How about this one?
Oh, my God. That is disturbing. Nobody needs to see that, bro. There's no need for anyone to see that. You're a fucking freak for that. Crazy.
Why would she do this?
Oh, why would she do that?
I don't know. Why would she do that?
If you want to see what we're talking about, join the Patreon and or go on the Reddit and look at it. And you'll see what exactly what we're talking about. Oh, my God.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, that's a Chinese letter. A
lot of ERs in that one.
You guys belong in hell.
Oh, not the... I created the coronavirus. Don't say it.
Roro. Yeah, because you know he will.
I know he would.
It should give... It should give you a medal for.
I don't want to say it.
Yes, you do.
I don't want to say it.
Say it. You won't.
No, I'm not that type of person.
Yes, you are.
Not when I'm live.
Oh, damn, I left my iPad. I had all my shit set up there. Fuck. Left it in the truck.
Fuck.
It's fine. I can set it up right here. Go get it. No, I'm not going to go. This is not. Fuck. I can just set it up right here on my phone. I
can get it. Did y'all have a good day today?
Yeah. It was all right.
Great day.
Yeah, I had a good day.
We're going to go get into our release dates. Oh, shit.
Come on, phone. Released.
So, right off the bat, Nike SB Dunk Low, Court Purple, dropping January 27th today, day of recording. So, they'll be out. By the time you hear this,
they're probably still there on Nike.com. Let me click on it and see if it pops up.
It is a...
sold out.
It is a SB Dunk Low.
Very mid shoe.
Basically a panda with like a purple on the back.
That's what makes it cool, very guys.
Very mid.
$115. It's a no for me.
Yeah.
I like the SB Dunk, but...
Nah, I don't fuck with that.
This is would be a good fuck around skate shoe. If I was a skater...
Oh, I guess we didn't do fit check either.
Okay, we can go straight.
Did we do fit check? Fuck it.
Let's do fit check.
We're already in the news.
Fuck it. We'll do it right after. Fuck it.
Go to Patreon if you want to hear the
fit check. I just fit say, check. I'm ready to kill somebody with this fit.
Nook if you book, boy.
Yeah, I got the nook if you books. Next year
Jordan
we have,
Airship Midnight Navy.
I would shoot myself in the ankle before I bought this.
Damn, you hate really? That much? Damn.
Because it's basically what you have on now.
Yeah, just different, a little different.
I hate the black.
It's not black, it's navy. Navy.
That's blue.
It's like blue. This color.
Am I blonde?
Yeah, it's like this.
It's far.
What do you mean it's like that?
This is navy.
That's a cream
that color,
right? That's a cream
it's
color.
It's white.
Oh, it's white?
It's white with a like navy.
Oh, okay. Damn. I got 20/20 vision.
Very generic.
I don't sound colorblind. Like yeah. Oh, this is a better picture. You can see a lot much more. See.
No, I don't like the blue at the top. I don't.
Very generic.
Well, it's an airship. Me. If you know what the airship is, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I do.
Okay, just make sure.
But, that's just okay. I'm not gonna say I love it or I hate it. It's just
okay. Man. Well, it comes out,
comes out today. $140.
$140. I can easily look.
Probably. I don't know. It might sell out, but I don't feel like they go crazy on resale.
No. I don't think they for sure.
I think you can get basically any colorway of this. Basically.
When I played basketball at the Boys and Girls Club,
not resale prices.
Always had a pair of Jordan 6s on.
Market price.
Great ankle support, light, comfy. I love them. Love Jordan 6s.
Would you wear this new one?
My bad.
Oh, absolutely. Uh-huh. I would wear this one.
The Air Jordan 6 yellow ochre.
Oh, absolutely. 110%.
I do like those shoes. I don't know if I will wear them, though. I don't know if
I don't like a Jordan 6.
January 27th for $200 on Nike.com. So it came out today.
When I played for the Mavericks. And the Celtics.
I do like them, but maybe not for me, you know? Yeah. Like, I appreciate their style, but overall for me, it's...
Yeah, like, I understand the history of the shoe or whatever.
Yeah, but...
It's just not a shoe I like. I've had 6s in the past. Just found them uncomfortable.
I think I
my mic sounds like you. It's quiet. Hello?
No, let me see. I can hear you.
There you go. Okay. Okay, better. All right, next shoe we have, I'm just going to go over real quick, is the Nike Dunk Low SC in the Dance colorway, which is a great school for your kid, January 28th for $95.
9 out of 10.
It's a kid shoe.
I like those.
Love them. It's a kid shoe.
I like those. Love them. Those are very nice.
I think whoever made those pink ones should drink batter, yes.
We're not going to look at those because they're basketball shoes and Next one we have is a Nike Air Force One Low in the Year of the Dragon. As you know, Nike does all the Chinese New Year shoes.
Right.
This year is the Year of the Dragon.
I like that.
This comes out with $135 on February 1st on Nike.com.
10 out of 10.
They come with the little shoe, I guess a shoe, a little bracket tab, whatever it is, where it usually has the Air Force logo. Yeah.
Did you?
It has the, what'd you say?
Nothing.
Did you? Is that how you say it?
No.
Okay. Either way, it has a little thing, little metal, little ornament on it. I don't know what it is. I can't really tell what it is. I gotta look at the thing.
Some type of like pearled lace look.
Yeah, it looks dope as fuck though. I like those. I like those.
Lace Dubre charm. I don't know what the Lace Dubre charm is.
It looks like it's a dragon inspired. So it's like some type of dragon thing with like what looks like a artificial pearl in the middle. Pretty clean.
Oh, Dubre is what it's actually called.
Yeah.
For the actual thing. Okay. I didn't know it was called Dubre.
Dubre.
This shoe is February 1st for $135. Really nice shoe. The next one I have is the Nike Dunk Low in Vintage Michigan colorway. Michigan colorway is the black, tour yellow, midnight. Shout out Michigan for winning the college football playoffs. Shout out Jim Harbaugh for going to the LA Chargers.
All the time.
You know the Dave?
Yeah.
Okay. No. I'm not. I respect it, though, but I'm not Notre Dame.
They're okay.
Yeah, so
my uncle went there. I grew up going to games with my dad. We always would go.
Okay.
Watch them either play, like, Michigan or the Tar Heels.
Okay. The hell was that?
Was that your dog?
Hold on. Oh, those are your neighbors or something. Okay.
Huh. Oh, yeah. It's like outside.
Yeah. Okay, we're good. These, you know, being loud, you know.
Were they talking?
Yeah, they're talking.
Oh, okay.
Next shoe is the Nike Air Footscape woven in the rainbow colorway, February 2nd for $160.
Ugly.
You don't like them?
No.
Why not?
No, bro.
Yes.
This reminds you of the Merrill one, the jungle you were talking about.
Oh, yeah, we have the...
Not for me.
Okay, so what do you think between this one and the one me and Colin about to show you? Let's see. What do you think? Hold on.
These are enough for me. It's just...
We have a...
I can...
Preview of Merrill One Trails 2024.
Too much of a crazy shoe.
What do you think about this one? Yeah. In that one, what do you think between those two? Which one you would think is you'd be like, okay,
like this one better, bro.
Why between those two? Why do you like that one? Put the mic by your mouth, please. Pause. Thank you.
No, actually, maybe I would like those better. Actually,
why though?
Now,
see, look, there's different ones. Look, look, there's you know, the brown one.
The shape.
Oh my god.
The shape of those would not go with me.
Terribly.
I feel like I can rock these.
Yeah. Those right there anyway. Look like those. Two different brands though.
When I see that,
two different brands.
I like the shape better.
So I guess the first one is a. We have no model names for these, but the first one is like a. It kind of looks like a Hoka trail shoe, where it's a Hoka with a kind of detachable sleeve. That you can put over it. That's made of Gore-Tex to make it waterproof.
Wear those. I will look like a clown if
I don't like the colorway.
Shoes, dude.
Do you fuck with the model at all? I would maybe like it without the shroud.
I think that's. Oh my god!
Yeah, I think, like, just to let you know, Merrill's more of a functional brand. Like, those are like hiking shoes.
I like those.
I feel like they'd be cool without the shroud.
Yeah, you're not going to be hiking in Air Force Ones, and if you are, you're crazy. Like,
if you were,
I would never hike in Air Force Ones.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but I would wear a hiking boot.
Some crazy, like,
that's a hiking boot.
Or something like that, like something baggy.
That's what I'm saying. That's a hiking boot.
It would look fucking dope, bro. Like a long jacket, too, like a windbreaker type of thing, you know, like long.
I tell you, that's what I'm saying. These Merrell is a functional brand. Yeah. Their things are made for functionality.
It looks like an Agility Peak 5 or maybe the new Agility Peak 6.
If I go hiking, dude, then definitely.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
I think those are really cool.
Would you wear those or would you wear those? If you're going to go hiking, you want a nice, cool-looking hiking boot, right?
That looks unique, too.
Yeah.
And I think it's really cool.
Yeah, but between the two that we saw, you like that one more, the Footscape Woven.
So then they have what I think is an MQM Ace is coming out with the cowl print and the white.
What do you think?
I like those, but just not for me. Not for me. The shape can...
What about the brown versions?
No, that shape, that type of shoe.
What about these, the water booties?
No, bro. I don't even.
Yeah, so there's a brown version.
No,
it looks like a all cowhide. You
fuck with these Crocs?
I'm not gonna lie to you.
That's something I'm wearing.
These go fucking hard.
These go fucking hard.
I like these the most out of all of them.
There is a watermark, like a all watermark, like covered boot.
Yeah. These are rain boots.
Like, if I see someone with those, I'll be like, oh, dude, you look really cool, but I could never do that, you know? Like,
you want to wear rain boots in the rain, bro?
I they remind me of Bottega boots.
I don't think I can rock those, bro. Like, I wouldn't know how.
In the rain, bro. That's how you rock them, in the rain. You know, it's made to go in the rain. Like I said, it's functional.
But see,
they remind me of the Bottega boots.
Those are the Bottegas. Bottega.
You know, this is like an $800 boot.
I would rather wear that situation.
Look, Jarrell, look at this one. Those are Bottegas.
These are Bottegas.
And
these
are Merrell.
This is an $800 boot. That's probably going to be like $125.
I kind of wish they were longer.
You know? Yeah.
If I had to wear them, I would wear that version.
Like a little higher.
I'd wear the Bottegas.
What do you think?
I don't know. I kind of like the Merrells. I'm not going to lie.
I'd rather wear the Merrells before the Bottegas.
It's a little more sport techy.
I promise you, if I wore those, bro, I would look
more gore.
Fucking clown. Like,
bro, they're made for the rain. They're functional.
You would not stop roasting me.
Hey, bro. I won't roast you if you're wearing rain boots in the rain. I'll probably be like, Dad, that was smart.
You look like you could run. You look like you can run a kitchen in those. Like, you would have Texas Roadhouse on lock.
Yeah, it's you against the world.
Yeah, chef.
I don't fuck with the Croc, but I'll fuck with the Merrell Hydro Mocs.
Yeah, I've seen the ones you have. I would rather wear the Hydro Moc more than the Croc. I don't fuck with Crocs. Ain't a Croc person.
Yep, me neither. Fuck Crocs. I think they're fucking ugly.
Yeah, so.
Hey, but you do you. If you like them, you like them. It is what it is.
Next shoe we have is the Nike Dunk Low in the Light Armory Blue colorway. It is February 2nd for $135 on Nike. It is a coconut milk sandriff hemp light armory blue. So pretty much neutral colors besides the bright blue on the Nike swoosh laces, insole, and heel tab. The outsole is like a faded gum bottom and the midsole is cream. And while the paneling and the medial and lateral sides and are like the front is the what is that color coconut milk
like
or the sandriff hemp and the back is the coconut milk.
I like them. I wouldn't get them for me, but
two different color laces like too. A cream, the coconut milk lace, and the blue.
That's so
I like those.
These are how they look like.
Nice.
Yeah, these are nice. I see these. I'd be like, okay,
those
good.
Nice.
Like, I just want to know what the quality of the suede is.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah, it better be good quality suede.
I don't think it's gonna be great quality suede for that price. I don't think it is.
No way. I didn't know about this one. Next shoe I just want to bring up real quickly is the Nike Air, or not the Nike, Air Jordan Mule Golf.
No.
In the bread colorway. Jesus. No. So these look like a deconstructed Air Jordan Low. God.
It's a Jordan 1 Mule.
Yeah, and it's a mule when and that's it's a golf shoe.
Anomaly,
it's awful.
Awful.
So it's golf. So
look, even if you're playing golf, no.
If you wear these in the golf, you got to be 86 years old.
Douchebag.
You got to be 86 years old or a douchebag. No, you got to be 86 or a douchebag.
You're either holding somebody up or you're charging somebody up for like taking too like.
You for sure called me a spick if you wear these.
Honestly, those are disrespectful. Honestly, just beyond.
Would you rock?
Beyond ugly, no. No, dude, that's a,
not at my enemy's funeral, bro.
Not at my enemy's damn.
I hope
damn, you don't like them at all.
I hope I never see anyone with those shoes, bro. Because I will.
Well, don't go to the golf course. You might be surprised.
I will have to roast them. Be like, hey, amen.
The Jordan?
Excuse me,
Michael. I wonder if Michael seen these shoes and he gave him the approval or not.
You seen him MJ dress, bro?
Yeah, he probably was like, dude, I got the best like long jeans.
With these. MJ don't know nothing. About
he's rich. It doesn't matter.
He's rich beyond anything.
Literally.
He's a billionaire, pretty much.
I made baggy shorts cool. I'm gonna make baggy pants cool.
Right.
I love
Kevin Hart.
I'm gonna get a Hitler mustache.
Kevin Hart used to go in on his outfits, and MJ would get so mad, bro. He would get so mad.
Oh shoot, I can tell. Oh, that'll be the last one I'm talking about because that one comes out next week.
Heard that.
Yeah, that one's next week. Yeah. So another, just a quick announcement. I believe Air Max is going crazy this year because they're collaborating one with the Armand Manier.
Air Max?
Yeah, with Nike. The Armand Manier and Nike Air Max are collaborating on
What type of Air Max? 91?
95, my bad. 95. So let me go ahead and pull that up for you.
I'm not a big fan of the 95.
I will say I like these a lot.
I think it's going to be a women's.
That's fine. I have a women's Armand Manier. I usually, you know, I don't care. As long as they have my size, I'll rock it. I don't give a fuck.
Ooh, I see a new colorway of the Nike Loon or Lunar Rome.
Yeah.
I like the shoe a lot.
They look comfy, though. I could rock those.
I like the original colorway better.
I don't like.
So these are
the whole black. I like the other ones.
Josh, these are the Armand Manier 95s.
I saw those, bro. Yes. I love the colors, bro. I love the shoe, but and I honestly thought about getting them, but that shape just doesn't go.
I have some 95s. So I can rock. I can rock 95s.
That
and some like joggers. Crazy. I'm going crazy.
For my body style, like I can't rock
Air Jordan 5. Armand Manier Nike.
Those are dope, though.
Or an Air Max 95. You don't like them?
I've never liked the Air Max 95.
Okay. Yeah. 95s are...
I like 95s.
But are they very comfortable? Yes.
I've seen some people rocking them. They look really good on, you know.
I love mine. That's probably
I love mine too.
My favorite Air Max is probably the Air Max Plus, but after that, it's probably the 95.
For me, it's 90, dude. Air Max 90. Those are my 90s and ones, but 90s overall.
Okay, so the next one I have, I gotta pull it up.
There's the OG color, right?
Yeah,
I like that color.
The Lunar Rome.
I don't like the whole black.
But
the next one I have is for the 95s. Is the not 95s Air Max is the Como de Garcon collaboration they have
with Hoka.
No, with the Nike, with the Air Max TL 2.5 pack.
Those are coming out. But they're also doing a shoe with Hoka. Did you see that?
Yeah. I saw that one.
Those are cold.
This is the Hoka.
Those are nice. I love those.
Yeah.
I love those. And they look fucking comfortable. Jesus.
But that, I think, is the new Air Max model for the new year.
Those look very dope. I like those a lot. I love the material too.
This is the newer way.
I kind of like those.
Honestly. See, these are the black ones right here.
I honestly.
They come in different colorways.
Different colorways.
Air Maxes?
Yeah. No, they're MX TLs. They're different.
The TL 2.5.
I kind of like them. I kind of like them, honestly.
So they come in three different colorways. The first one is the white one you see right there, like this one.
I would like a different colorway.
Then they have the black one.
No, like a different color.
Yeah, I'd like to see what kind of like
right.
crazy colorways they black. Can do with it.
White and
black. Well, Comer the Garçon usually
do yeah, they just only white do really white and black.
White and black.
They're pretty simple.
Crazy. Yeah, Comer the Garçon. The white and black you like?
White and black was crazy. And
yeah, I like those the most.
The white one looks
clean.
Clean.
Like, I feel like I wear if I'm wearing that, I better stay crispy all day.
I would wear
those. These look like I'm about to rob somebody.
Yeah, no.
I like them a lot.
Black ones.
So
the white ones. You get married, I like the shape.
These are the white ones.
I like the shape, honestly.
These are the black ones.
I like the shape a lot.
I like the white ones.
And then I like the white and blacks.
The white and black looks crazy, too.
Comes out in fall 2024, so you have all year to save up money to try to get these.
I would like to see different colors, though. Like,
but they don't. Comme des Garçons only does white and black. They've always just done white and black. Almost all of their shoes are white and black or see through.
I would just like to see that shape in different colors. You know, maybe or
they have them in different colors. The TL pack, they have the Air Max TL like in completely different colors. Okay,
I gotta look into
that. That one's just like that's their collab with the TL 2.5.
Yeah, took it.
Yeah, look, there's a lot of them, different ones. This one has probably all of them right here, all the different ones.
More colorways of the Nike Air Terra Humara Undefeated. Coming.
I like
this,
that one.
This is a fucking fire.
That's a fire colorway.
It's like a green.
Fuck. I like those, but just maybe not for me. This is very unique, though. I like the details on it. The materials are crazy too, though.
Yeah,
the shape is really cool too.
I like it. I like it.
I'm not gonna say I don't like.
I don't have the money to buy it right now.
Yeah,
it comes out in a couple months. So
perfect. I might have money then, depending if this big purchase comes through or not.
Just get the Jordan 1's Dragon.
Anything else worthy of comment?
Yeah.
Oh, more Jacquemus Nike.
Yeah, we say Jacquemus Nike's coming out with some shit. Baguette. Wine. Eiffel Tower. I think we're at a good spot for now.
Well, that's all, folks. Go over to patreon.com
Fargo.
Let's talk about some very real events.
Oh, yeah.